So I'm really old. So I remember the days, like in the early days of the internet, if you like, we had like lots of weird protocols like IPX, and TCP wasn't the only game in town, right? NetBEUI, all these other weird protocols. It sounds like that's kind of the same problem we have today with like these agentic protocols. Is that kind of true to say?
That's exactly where we are. And so we are talking about AppleTalk, DECnet, and SNA, and all these weird protocols. But if you think about the internet, there is, of course, there is TCP, and there's also UDP and QUIC.
So I'm slow. So the agency consortium that you've created, it's open source, firstly. And what is it providing again?
So if you think about, again, this platform that we're talking about, the Internet of Agents, and if you harken back to the original internet, or if you take the movie-making example that we just talked about, what does it take to bring a group of individuals in the human world to come together, collaborate, and do something useful and credible at the same time? Absolutely. And I think if you think about enterprises, you were always dealing with deterministic situations, and the gap between that and where we are headed with probabilistic, that's where agentic strategies go to die. So enterprises need to invest in things like Internet of Agents and get started right now.
Everyone, David Bumble back with Vijoy. Vijoy, great to have you back on the show.
It's always a pleasure, David.
Outshift, you guys do some amazing stuff, lots of cool technology. We'll talk about quantum in a different video. But in this video, we're going to talk about agency or Internet of Agents. Can you give us an update? Because you kind of teased us previously.
Yeah, so we are super excited. Back in Amsterdam, we were talking about the Internet of Agents. And I think I was mentioning we were about to release open source around it. But basically, the theory behind Internet of Agents is we are all moving from deterministic computing to probabilistic computing. And we are moving from cloud computing, which was deterministic, to probabilistic agentic computing. And the whole thesis behind agentic computing is that smaller, more accurate agents, almost like human subject matter experts, come together in a team to collaborate to then do higher order outcomes for your business. So think of it as like the movie making industry, where you have directors and actors and screenwriters all coming together, all really good at their job, coming together and collaborating to build that movie or create that movie. The problem is there is no platform for these agents to come together and collaborate. So the Internet of Agents is exactly that platform. It's an open, interoperable, quantum-safe platform for agent-to-agent collaboration. And so we launched the vision back in December. And in March, we launched the open source collective behind it. It's called Agency. It's A-G-N-T-C-Y. It misses the E vowel, so be careful when you go there. So agency.org. And it's right as of now, it's 50 plus partners that are working towards this goal.
So agentic AI, Internet of Agents, that's the same kind of thing, right?
Agentic AI is the thesis behind agents doing autonomous action on behalf of users or businesses. And the Internet of Agents is the platform that allows these agentic AI nodes or pieces of software to come together, collaborate to solve a higher order problem, which is a consumer problem. It could be a business problem. It could be a scientific problem or a physical embodied robotics problem.
So I'm slow. So the agency consortium that you've created, it's open source, firstly. And what is it providing again?
So if you think about, again, this platform that we're talking about, the Internet of Agents, and if you harken back to the original internet, or if you take the movie-making example that we just talked about, what does it take to bring a group of individuals in the human world to come together, collaborate, and do something useful and credible at the same time? So first and foremost, you need to discover talent, right? So if you think about the movie industry, you're discovering actors and directors and screenwriters. So there is a discovery problem. Part of the discovery problem is the identity problem, because are you really discovering Steven Spielberg, or are you discovering somebody else, right? So there is an identity problem. Once you've discovered people and subject matter experts, you need to then bring them together so that they start collaborating. So from discovery, you get to composition in the agentic world, where you're bringing all of these agents together, compose them in a workflow or a self-forming task to solve for the business outcome. So that's step two. Step three is then you deploy them. So you actually go towards the task of building that movie out or solving that business need. So that's the deployment phase. And then finally, it's the evaluation. I mean, just because Steven Spielberg said, I'm going to make a great movie, I mean, he's had some doubts. So just make sure that he's doing what he's supposed to do. So the observability and evaluation is the last phase. So agency takes a look at that entire life cycle of agents collaborating. So discovery and identity, composition, deployment, and observe and eval. And we've worked with, again, 50 plus partners to actually drop open source for each one of these phases. So there's a discovery registry, there's identity that we just released a couple of weeks ago. There's a composition piece, there's observability that we're extending open telemetry, but also there's a whole set of new problems that we're tackling in the evaluation phase as well.
Just help me because I'm slow as always. You mentioned deterministic and what was the other term?
Probabilistic.
So what's the difference with that? And like, is deterministic like when you talk to a machine, you know you're going to get something very specific back, but with agents, it could like be very varying and changed. Or can you give us a proper definition?
Yeah, so that's exactly right. I mean, so if you with machines and software, you can poke an API, which is a well-structured query and deterministic in nature. There's no ambiguity there. It's machine code. And what you get back is a well-structured response, which is also very deterministic. There's no ambiguity around it. But with agents, again, agents are like humans at machine speed and scale, which means you are asking NLP questions and you're getting responses which are also NLP-like in nature, even though it might be in a machine-readable format, but they're probabilistic in nature. So how do you deal with that ambiguity? And the other thing is, like, as you deal with that ambiguity, it also has ramifications to assurance, things like assurance. How do you guarantee anything in that world? And also, it has ramifications on state. Like when you and I talk to each other and we are pointing at videos and images, agents are going to do the same thing. So we're going to see a lot of state exchanges in probabilistic domains, and that's what we need to handle.
So I understand the concept of agents or agentic AI. They use a protocol called MCP, if I understand correctly. What is this doing different, like to like just getting and building my own agent or like just downloading an agent or something?
So that's a great one that you brought up. So MCP is one of the protocols. There are many, many protocols. As of last count, I think there were like 13 plus protocols in this space. And to us, we would like it to be one protocol, but we are also Cisco and we are in the multi-protocol game. Yeah. So we can build a multi-protocol router, not a problem at all.
Yeah.
But for the industry as a whole, it would be great if we converge on one. And so if you think about MCP and the way it began, MCP is Model Context Protocol. So it started with providing data or tool or function calling context to a model. So it's super useful in building agents, but it started out from agents to data and tools. And then we released a protocol called ACP, Agent Connect Protocol, which was agent to agent. Then Google released a protocol called A2A, which was agent to agent. And so, like I said, as of today, there are like 13. And I wouldn't be surprised if they're like 20 plus in the next 6 months. But the bigger thing here, David, is protocols are just a small piece of this entire puzzle
Okay. That
we just talked about. So let's say I gave you a phone line and said, you know, this is the phone line for you to call a plumber and figure out how can I get a plumber to my house to fix a leaky sink. That's great. That's a protocol. I gave you something to talk to somebody else. But where is the white pages or yellow pages to actually go in and figure out where the plumber is, what their phone number is? That's number one.
Okay, yeah.
Number two, is that plumber like Yelp or something else? Like, is that plumber trusted? How are the reviews, right? That's number two. So there's a reputation aspect of it. There's an identity aspect of it. It's like, is the plumber registered with the Santa Clara County or something, right? So can I trust it, right? And then finally, like, the plumber comes over, does the job. It's like, did you do what you promised to do? Or did you just patch up something and disappear? So there's an evaluation piece to it. So there are many, many pieces in this, even the simple example, where the protocol is great, but like there's assurance. Like when I talk to the plumber, am I going to get dropped?
Yeah.
Is a plumber even going to pick up that line on the other end? Again, these are examples from the old internet days or the telephone days, but there are similar problems that exist in the agentic space, but they are net new in many, many ways.
So I'm really old. So I remember the days, like in the early days of the internet, if you like, we had like lots of weird protocols like IPX, and TCP wasn't the only game in town, right? NetBEUI, all these other weird protocols. It sounds like that's kind of the same problem we have today with like these agentic protocols. Is that kind of true to say?
That's exactly where we are. And so we are talking about AppleTalk, DECnet, and SNA, and all these weird protocols. But if you think about the internet, there is, of course, there is TCP, and there's also UDP and QUIC, and there are other protocols as well. So there are protocols, but there is DNS. There's VeriSign providing, I mean, just VeriSign is one of them, but providing authentication and identity. There's telemetry like SNMP that you use to figure out whether things are working well. So there's an entire gamut of capabilities that you need, not just TCP, UDP, or QUIC, to build out the internet. And we are building something similar on the agentic layer.
So agencies, is that in some way similar to like the Google Play Store, where I can get apps, or I can get something from the Apple Store and like download agents in the similar way kind of thing? Or is it more than that?
So it's actually more like, let's say, the Cloud Native Computing Foundation, CNCF. So you go to CNCF and you can actually, there's a Kubernetes cluster manager. There is there's OpenTelemetry for telemetry and observability. There's Spiffy Spire for identity and authorization. So there are all of these building blocks in open source. There's a Docker registry. There's a way to describe containers, specifications. So there are all of these building blocks that allow someone to create cloud-native applications, either on-prem or on their cloud footprint. It doesn't matter. And it's all open source, it's open spec. Think of it as the same set of capabilities, but for the agentic layer. So it's a bunch of open source code, specifications, and services that anybody can use to create their agents, compose their agents, discover other agents within their organization from third party, like a Salesforce or a Workday, glue them together into workflows, solve a business need, and then measure that business need and provide them identity and assurance and trust.
So how is it different to say CNCF or like other examples out there? Or can you give me like some examples practically so that people can envision how agency actually looks like and functions?
Yeah, so I think CNCF is a good parallel to draw here, like we just did. But I think one of the things that we looked at when we looked at CNCF and the cloud native layer, in fact, is it was built for the deterministic world and we're moving to a probabilistic world. And so you're seeing all of these agents that are really, they have human-like attributes and human-like behavior and human-like capabilities, but they operate at machine speed and scale. So it's a blend of humans and machines. And everything that we've done in infrastructure so far has been either to tackle humans, which are probabilistic and intelligent, but slow, or machines and software, which are deterministic, but operate at incredible speed and scale. And now when you bring those two worlds together, which is what agents are, you get into a place where you have intelligent probabilistic outcomes and inputs operating at machine speed and scale. So simple examples, instead of poking an API, which is deterministic intent, and you get a deterministic answer back, this is the answer, it's binary. You ask questions like, find me the best X. And what comes back is, this is the best X with 90% confidence. Best is probabilistic, which is intent, and the outcome is 90% probabilistic. So how do you build a layer which tackles this non-determinism at machine speed and scale, and all of the observability, evaluation, security, trust, risks that come with it? And that's what we're trying to solve with agency. And again, the other principle here is we are not trying to reinvent what has been done. So we are standing on the shoulders of giants, so to speak. So we are building the entire agency layer on top of the cloud native computing foundation layer. And we are, when it needs to be reinvented, or not reinvented, but invented, we do it. But when we can leverage things, we leverage things. So all of our protocols, for example, sit upon gRPC as an example. I mean, the entire orchestration mechanism is containerized as an example. So we're not reinventing that entire stack.
Can you give me an example so that it's more concrete? Because it's like hard to imagine perhaps so people are watching?
Yeah, so I think it's easy to build all of this. We are all infrastructure people. But the big question is, so what? I mean,
yeah, exactly.
Are we just geeking out or we are just having fun or there's something real? So let me start with where we started with this problem from, right? And this happened in Cisco, which is a regular enterprise, if you think about it, and our IT teams coming across SaaS software that they use and love, like Salesforce, Microsoft, Workday, ServiceNow. And all of these SaaS products are actually becoming agentic in nature. Now, when you have a use case such as stand up a sales funnel for me, you could just point at a few clicks on a few UIs, and I'm simplifying it. IT is hard, operations is hard. But you could just do that and you could write some glue code and voila, you have that thing stood up and then you can scale it and manage it and secure it. So on it. With agentic, what is happening is now you have to have an agentic interface to Salesforce and ServiceNow and Microsoft and Cisco to secure and things like that. And so we were getting to the problem of how do these endpoints, which are probabilistic in nature, talk to each other, collaborate with each other to solve for an outcome. So that's where we started. But we've also rolled out a bunch of applications already within Cisco. So we've rolled out an SRE app called Jarvis. It's 20 plus agents. It's already reduced our SRE workload by 3 SRE engineers.
Wow.
It's automated 30% of our tasks to go from hours to seconds. And it's we are working with a whole bunch of other players out there to make it open source and available to everybody else. Doing the same thing with service providers and the entire network configuration pipeline and validation pipeline and debugging pipeline. So these are real hard use cases where 20 plus, 30 plus agents are coming together and they're all talking their own languages, but you somehow need to bring them together in a team to collaborate and solve for a business need. And that's what agency is all about.
Dejoy, it's always great talking to you and seeing the future. We're unfortunately out of time. I have to get you back for some more of this. It sounds like based on the keynote today and like what I'm hearing in the industry, this is becoming more and more important. And it's great to see that Cisco doing stuff in this space to make it easier for us.
Absolutely. And I think if you think about enterprises, you were always dealing with deterministic situations and the gap between that and where we are headed with probabilistic, that's where agentic strategies go to die. So enterprises need to invest in things like Internet of Agents and get started right now.